Syanna gave me a drawing today.
Charming.
Of freshly decapitated bodies covered in blood.
Perhaps not so much.
I asked her why ever she would draw such a thing. Her Highness claimed it was a rendering of nightmares which have plagued her for as long as she can remember. Syanna does wake up screaming nearly every night, save when she shares a bed with Honorietta. Curse of the Black Sun. Supposedly, girls afflicted by it had horrible dreams. Kind of horrible that made some of them go mad. The girls quarreled today. I must note rather sadly they did not behave as befits future ladies. The incident devolved into fisticuffs. Anna Henrietta was first to strike her sister. Syanna gave back as good as she'd gotten. By the time I separated them, Honorietta had lost two teeth. She ran off to complain to her parents. His Grace the Duke refused to believe my version of events. He laid all the blame on Syanna and vowed to punish the little one harshly. Honorietta did her best to have her sister's sentence commuted, but the Duke and Duchess proved unbending.
Once you're labeled a black sheep, it's so hard to shed the reputation.
Mages sent by the Conclave arrived today. They came to examine Syanna. I cannot know what conclusions they drew, but His Grace now seems clearly upset.
Curse of the Black Sun. There's no doubt then that she was diagnosed with the syndrome symptoms.
Or had that label planted on her. It goes on. I dared ask the Duke what would become of the girl. He did not reply.
Welcome back to another Witcher lore video, guys. So I was replying to YouTube comments the other day, and I saw a suggestion from this user that I thought was actually a really, really good suggestion for a video. Because this part of Witcher lore is something that confused me, as I was never quite sure of how it worked, as there seemed to be a lot of inconsistencies with the games and the books. So I decided to make today's video on the Curse of the Black Sun. So the way in which I've decided to structure today's video is by pretty much asking myself questions that I would want to know if I knew nothing about the Curse of the Black Sun. So to begin with, the first question I asked myself was who prophesied the curse? And the man who prophesied this curse was a mage known as Eltibold, or Eltibold. So some key information about this guy to know more about the Curse of the Black Sun is to know that many thought that he was a madman. Now, we don't know if people think he's a madman based on the fact that he came up with this curse that caused a lot of young girls to have terrible lives, or if they thought he was a madman based on how he was just as a person. But let's just say a lot of people thought he was a madman, so you've got to understand that he is not exactly the most trustworthy source. But you've got to also understand that a lot of people thought of him as a prophet. And these are obviously going to be the people that support his idea of the Curse of the Black Sun. So he also claimed that he deciphered this prophecy, this curse, whatever you want to call it, from Dauk, Bobalak, and Wazgore legends. And what the overall end point of this prophecy was the extinction of humanity, and this was by the return of an evil goddess. Which we'll get into later. So that's what you need to know about who prophesies this curse. And the next question I asked myself was what was in this prophecy? What did it contain? What was the prophecy in full? So to begin with, as I stated at the end there, it prophesies that the Black Sun would announce the return of Lilith. And this is pretty much just an evil goddess. I'll get into her in later videos, but for now, all you need to know is that Lilith was an evil goddess. And after her return, it would result in the extermination of the entire human race. So another part of this prophecy, which I would say is the part that has affected the games, the books, and everything else within the Witch universe the most, is that when she would return, she would be welcomed by 60 girls born under the Black Sun, who would fill the valleys with blood. So the implication behind that prophecy is obviously that these girls would, I guess, exterminate humanity or a large portion of it, and then when Lilith comes, the entire race would just be exterminated. Along with, I imagine, all the non-humans on the world as well. So of course, this gives speculation that these 60 girls were thought to be evil and possessed by demons, or cursed, or just contaminated in some way. Basically, these girls were all thought to be evil. So just to interject slightly, I want to discuss what the Black Sun actually is. And this part had me quite confused, because I wasn't sure if the Black Sun applied to all solar eclipses that would occur in the Witch universe. Because, say in our actual world that we come from, a solar eclipse occurs every 18 months. But after looking over it a lot, it appears that the Curse of the Black Sun, at least the eclipse that came with that, was a single event. Because a lot of the girls born under this one particular solar eclipse appeared to be mutated in some some way. And yet again, I'm not sure if they were actually mutated or maybe a lot of the parents at that time were scared of the curse of the Black Sun so treated their children terribly, but there does appear to be some sort of correlation here. So the curse of the Black Sun, to summarize, at least after looking a lot, appears to be one event in which a lot of people were born that turned out to be evil in some way later in their life. So anyway, continuing from that interjection, the question I also asked was, what was the reaction of the people in the world after they found out about this prophecy? So obviously, a lot of people doubted this, and they said, well, you know, you're not a very trustworthy guy, we think you're mad, we're not gonna listen to you. But there were a lot of people who took it as the truth, and then acted quite dramatically. And a lot of the people that acted dramatically were the mages and wizards, and also sorceresses, sorcerers, etc. So what happened is that people then hunted down these girls, and either killed them, or tried to find out what was different about these girls, and this was by performing autopsies. So eventually they began to realize that it was very difficult to determine if a girl was born under the Black Sun or not using autopsies and other methods. So what they decided to do is if they thought a girl was born under the Black Sun, they would lock them away in a tower. This actually caused a, I guess you could say, almost like a cultural phenomenon where princes would then go and rescue them, and a lot of them would fall over and break their necks. But it was just a strange little thing that princes decided to do. So after some time, some of the girls died, but some of them actually managed to escape. And you'll know this from reading the books. A lot of the girls weren't even put in towers in the books, they just escaped somehow from whatever was supposed to happen to them. And after they escaped their towers, or just escaped in general, they became too powerful for wizards to even bother dealing with them. For example, think about Renfri in the books. She managed to escape, and she managed to develop her own gang, and then the wizard ended up hiding from her. And if you don't know what I'm talking about then, I will get into Renfri in a later video. So another aspect of this curse that you've got to consider is that this curse could be completely self-fulfilling, because a lot of the evidence to support that this curse is real could easily be parried with saying something like, well, if you lock a girl in a tower her entire life, give her a terrible life, make her feel like she's evil, of course she's gonna end up pretty messed up. So that makes it a self-fulfilling prophecy. If you predict something and tell them, then eventually it will just happen. So the game seems to support the Black Sun more than it doesn't, as it does seem to show that Syanna did seem to have some psychopathic tendencies when she was younger. And I don't mean this in a horrible way, but she did used to have nightmares about people, say, being decapitated. And this was before a lot of things. I mean, it could just be entirely coincidental that she had these nightmares, but then again, coincidences in a magical universe generally aren't coincidences. But yet again, in the games, there is a lot of evidence to support that she became cruel because of what happened to her in her early life. And I'll get into all that in a later video, as I don't want to discuss Syanna too much, but what you've got to take away from this is that the curse has never been proven or disproven. So that's all I want to say on today's video. This video is just meant to be quite a basic rundown of what the curse of the Black Sun actually is and how it works, but to finally properly end today's video, I'm just going to name every single child that was thought to be born under the curse of the Black Sun, at least the ones that we know of. And don't worry, I'm not going to list 60 names, there's only a few. So there is Sylvenna, Fialka, Bernica of Tulgar, Renfri, Deirdre, and Syanna. You'll probably recognize the two last names most if you've seen the Price Neutrality DLC from the Witcher games, or played The Witcher 3 Blood and Wine and met Syanna. But if you've read the books, I imagine Renfri will be quite a big name for you to recognize there as well. So finally, to end today's video, I'm going to read the journal entry. Eltibold's prophecy had wide repercussions. To this day, the debate rages as to whether it proved true or the ravings of a madman. In all certainty, there occurred a solar eclipse, after which, many mutated girls were born. Some of them were isolated from society immediately, from whence the tales of princesses imprisoned in towers atop glass mountains and princes who set out to rescue them. Rumors abound regarding bloody female outcasts born under the Black Sun and resembling women only in appearance. Many say the creatures proved nothing more than cruel monsters. Mages agreed to explore the matter and proceed to employ various means in the investigations. Vivisections proved necessary in some cases, proving the only certain way of revealing the evil mutations. However, they could not agree on whether the internal anatomical deformations they discovered were decisive of the creature's evil nature. The curse of the Black Sun was prophesied by the mage Eltibold, who predicted the return of Lilith, a mythical being who is to bring ruin upon the world. Lilith's second coming will be preceded by the appearance of 60 maidens wearing gold crowns, who will fill the river valleys with blood, thus preparing the way. So that's all I'm going to say for today's video, guys. I honestly hope you've enjoyed it. This video was quite fun to make, and honestly has given me a much better understanding of the Black Sun, as I'm free to admit that I did not understand it as well as I thought I did before making today's video. But as always, guys, be sure to follow me on Twitter. I'm going to do updates on there pretty much every time I post a video. It's useful if you follow me on there, as you get all those updates, and you get to see when I post stuff. So yeah, be sure to go and follow me on there. Be sure to follow me on Twitch, as I plan to do some games on there at some point. There's been a lot of cool games announced at E3, so I'll probably be playing a lot of them on Twitch, as that would be easier to do. And as always, thank you so much to the Patreon pledges. You guys are just amazing. It's very, very nice what you guys do. And honestly, just, I got a new Patreon the other day, and it's just so nice whenever I see that. It's quite a cool thing when I go on my email and think, you know, oh, that guy's, you know, he's just thought, I like the videos and I'm going to donate. And it's just very, very kind of you. And of course, thank you to everybody who comments on the videos, likes the videos, and just supports the channel in any way you can, as it's very, very kind of you guys. And it honestly does help me out. So thank you all. But anyway, guys, I hope you've all enjoyed today's video and you've learned something new, and I'll see you all in the next video.